Hey guys, this is David Kwan, here to give just a brief impression of Real Racing 3, because I'm not done playing yet, although I did play a hell lot of it. I'm looking at my stats here, and apparently I played 16 hours and 41 minutes. Holy crap, I played a lot of this game. I currently own 10 cars, and yeah. So, I played a lot of it, but there's still so much content left to be unlocked. I've only raced around with one supercar, and there's still so many more cars and more events to partake in. So I'll make another video after I've done all that. But this is just kind of just brief impressions on this game, because it needs to be said. And what I want to say is, how is this possible? Like, how is this possible on a phone? Especially on an iPhone 4, which by now is about this model. Phone model is about 2 years old now. It's a really outdated phone. So, and I think even the phone realizes that. I think there are times when this phone asks that same question, and the frame rate just drops. It just starts stuttering like crazy, and I'm trying to play this game like really intense. Like, oh my gosh, I don't know what's gonna happen next, because the frames are skipping, and like it's lagging. The lag sometimes is almost game breaking, but I keep playing it because, like I said, how is it possible on an iPhone is not a negative question. It's a question of like just awe and just jaw-dropped awe. Like, this game looks so amazing. And most of the time it is not frame rate stuttering. Most of the time it is running smoothly. I'm just like, how is this possible on an iPhone 4? This looks better than anything the PS2 has ever shown, even with Gran Turismo 4. It's an amazing looking game. It's like Gran Turismo 4 HD version. It's not as good looking as, like, you know, PS3 360 racing games like, you know, Grid or Dirt or Forza or Gran Turismo 5. It's not up to that level, of course. You can't expect that out of a fucking phone, you know. But at the same time, it's not too far from there, which is amazing. The details on these cars are just sparkling awesome. I've seen some footages and screenshots of Real Racing 2. So that's the prequel to this EA mobile phone racing game. And the difference is actually quite stark. Real Racing 2 is probably like a PS2 game, whereas Real Racing 3 looks like a PS Vita game, or PS Vita almost PS3-ish game. Graphically, the technology behind this game is also just like, how is this possible? Time-shifted multiplayer is the big concept behind this game, and my mind still can't wrap around how this is possible. It's not perfect, but it's still like an amazing concept. The concept is, you have the lap times of people all across the world. I race, and then that lap, I have the lap time, so people all around the world have raced on this game, and they have their lap times. That number is translated into a car. They have an algorithm which turns it into a competing car in an offline event game. So you're racing against other people's lap times, but in actual car form. That's time-shifted multiplayer. It's amazing. It's brilliant. I don't know how it manages to do that. I've actually tried that offline, because I went underground in the subway. New York City subways, we have no cell phone reception whatsoever. So that always sucks. But I tried this out. I opened up Real Racing 3 and I started playing it. There was a lot of frame rate stutters, because I think the game is still trying to find that cellular data to download people's lap time, whatever, across the world. But I can still play it. I can still compete against other people, because other people's lap times are translated into a car that you compete against. Brilliant. So amazing. I don't even know how this is freaking possible. So on that front, this game is phenomenal. I can't believe this is possible on the phone. I keep repeating this just because I'm that awestruck by it. And it's really, really fun. I think I've had, like, just transitioning into becoming an expert player. There is no touch, you know, there's no buttons on this thing, but they've actually managed to make it playable like an actual just racing sim game. It's not like a mobile version of a racing game. It's not one of those endless runner type games. It's not a mobile game. It's actually a full-fledged racing game. Once I turned off all the assists, it took me gradually to do that, you know. I started out as, you know, and I have the controls as being, I hit this side of the phone to accelerate, and I hit this side of the phone for brake. And then I let go, and it just kind of, that's putting your foot off the accelerator pedal. And the way I control it is through the gyro, whatever you call this thing. I tilt it to the right to turn right, I tilt it to the left to turn right, or I do this to turn right, or I do this to turn left. And it's really responsive. The controls work so well. So much to the point that I turned off all assists. I turned off traction control, I turned off steering wheel assist, I turned off brake assist, accelerator assist, turned off everything. So, and then I'm able to control this race in real life courses like Suzuka Circuit, Laguna Seca, which is a bitch course. Like, I hate that course just because it can be so tough. But yeah, it works. It's beautiful, and I can play on the phone. It does have this grinding model, and it rewards anytime you play an event, whether you win first place or fifth place or 20th place, you do get some game currency out of it. So you're always rewarded, but not too much. And I think that's to encourage people to buy for the microtransactions. But I played 16 hours so far. I haven't paid any money, and I have 10 cars. One car is so awesome. It's the McLaren, I forgot the name of it, but it's a car that goes like up. The top speed is like 250 miles per hour. So it's a really super class car. And I've been able to buy that because I accrued enough, not the cash, real dollar cash, but this gold thingy. I accrued enough gold to buy it. And you accrue gold by completing events, by leveling up. It's a great system. And in fact, maybe later on, I am planning to put like $5 down or $10 down to purchase, you know, game money and buy something. Not because I really need to, not because I'm impatient or lazy, but just because this game is so awesome to me, I really want to support it. Even though the company behind it is EA, I feel like EA funded the development team behind this mobile app. And, you know, I think these big publishers moving into the mobile realm is not such a horrible thing. You know, they're able to put so much budget into their innovations or whatever. They're able to complete this, which seems so impossible on an iPhone 4. It feels so amazing to play this on this phone. I can't wait to talk even more about this game after I pretty much completed this game to the fullest extent that I could. And it's games like this that actually show that even big publishers on a platform where, you know, indie games and little developers thrive, you know, big publishers go in there and they do really awesome things too. Like Real Racing 3. And Activision has stepped into with like stuff like Pitfall, which is the obvious intent is there. Like, we want you to buy these microtransactions. The intent is there, but at the same time, Pitfall, for example, has so many innovations, brings so many new innovations to the endless runner genre that I can't really fault it, and has such a crazy cool art style to it. Real Racing 3 is in that manner, like, makes the racing sim experience available on iPhone 4 or any other iOS device, an iPad, whatever. I would love to have an iPad just to play Real Racing 3. That would be freaking phenomenal. But yeah, that's my first impression so far. One negative thing I have to say is the time-shifted multiplayer thing is brilliant, but at the same time, it makes it so that the AI of the car is not dynamic. It doesn't acknowledge your existence. It's on this preset path, or it feels like it. It does this behavior where it's just like, if it does it, it's a detriment to this guy, but he's doing it anyway. So I think if they can kind of iron out that and make time-shifted multiplayer, if they make Real Racing 4, make it so that not only does it incorporate lap time data, but also incorporate so that the AI is more dynamic and reacts to you as a player, that would be an even more phenomenal thing. And I would still be going like, how is this possible on a phone, you know?